What's cracking, guys? Omar Esoff here today. In this video, we're talking about everyone's favorite muscle. What is it?
The bicep.
When we first started training, most likely you were a chest and bicep bro.
You.
Some of us, you know, we gravitate now towards strength, performance, what have you, but one thing is clear. Biceps, or arms in general, represent a lot to guys. We want big arms. In this video today, I'm going to talk about some of the three most important factors that determine bicep size or arm size. We're going to talk about your wrist size. We're going to talk about where your actual bicep inserts. Then we're going to talk about genetics, your height, and how that plays in. So first, let's talk about wrist size. They found a strong correlation between your wrist size, the size of your wrist, and the eventual maximal size that your arm can be. I'm going to link it in the description below. Casey Butts, don't laugh. A smart guy. He's a smart guy. Man, ruining the video, Nigel. Where he did a study comparing a whole bunch of natural bodybuilders, and he found that ankle measurements and wrist measurements are good indicators for overall size, right? How big your arms can be, how big your thighs can be. So wrists positively correlate with your overall arm size. So if you got bigger wrists, most likely you could pack on more size on your arms or biceps. Next, we have to talk about insertions. Everybody cares about peaks. Yo, dog, you gotta get those peaks, gotta get those full muscle bellies. Now, what role do the genetics play when it comes to your biceps? A lot, actually, unfortunately. So, biceps, as the name implies, are two different muscles. There's your long head, and then there's your short head. They originate both roughly around your shoulder, and then they insert around your forearm. Now, depending upon where the actual bicep muscle inserts into the tendon will determine your peak, right? Those that have a higher insertion will have a higher peak because the bicep attaches, let's say, here as opposed to here. So when you flex, the bicep itself, it's shorter, so therefore the muscle mass is going to appear higher, like a peak. And this is entirely genetics. You can't do anything about this. And I know a lot of people are like, oh man, you know, I really want to build that peak. Peak depends, once again, upon genetics, your overall shape of the biceps. And that's why, you know, to flip it around, because there's always a pro and con, you know, depending on whether you got like a higher insertion or a lower insertion. What that means, if you have a lower insertion, it means you have more overall area. Your arm will probably be a little bit bigger, because let's take a look again. If your bicep inserts higher up, so here, instead of, let's say, down here, that's overall less area that your bicep will be. It might look good with a peak, but it also will be narrow. So there's pros and cons to everything. The third point I want to talk about height and overall body size, limb length, as it determines when it comes to bicep actual size. And here's what I'm talking about. Depending upon how long the limb is, will determine in ways how good the actual arm looks. And here's exactly what I mean. If you got a lanky motherfucker and he has 16 inch arms, I'm talking about a 6'9" jungle dude, right? 6'10", just a massive guy. If you have 16 inch arms over a long ass, you know, actual right here, long ass arm, it's not gonna look that big. You're gonna have to build, you know, 17, 18 inch arms. If you're smaller, however, proportions are smaller. So you're gonna look better. A 16 inch arm on a guy that's 4'11 or 5'2 or 5'1, bless your genetics, man, let's rule, right? Will look better than a guy that's 6'4", 6'5", that are taller. And so in a way, being shorter, as we know when it comes to bodybuilding, aids in symmetry, proportion, how the muscles actually look. So depending upon your limb length will help influence the amount of size that you need to put on your bicep to look good. See, there's pros and cons to everything. Everybody's like, oh, manly this, manly that. I tell you what, the smaller guy needs to put in less work, has a smaller arm, and they'll look more impressive than the guy that's bigger. The bigger guy will need to add overall more muscle mass to even look like they lift. As well, you know, when we talk about limb length, if you're born with long arms and said, oh, you can't pack on a lot of biceps, but I got news for you, son, you're gonna be able to deadlift a lot. So when it comes to biceps, genetics certainly play a role, and all the magazines will try, you know, sell you otherwise. Do this exercise for the peak. Really, it comes down to the insertion of the bicep itself. The long head and the short head, where it inserts on the tendon. So if it's higher up, you're gonna have a higher peak. What did we talk about today?
We already talked about biceps.
We talked about biceps. So we talked about building biceps, how big can you naturally get your biceps? We talked about three important factors, right? Your wrist size, which does correlate to your overall bicep size. Where your actual bicep inserts into the tendon will help influence the peak for the overall shape of it. And then finally, your limb length. The longer your limb, the more time and effort you gotta put in the gym to make it look fuller, your actual arm itself. That's it, that's the video. If you liked the video, make sure to like this damn video. And maybe if you wanna see a bicep routine, leave a comment below. I'll see all you guys, my rascals, in that next video. Peace.